Thank you. Welcome, everybody, and thank you for coming to the Art Center tonight. I know, parking was probably horrendous, and I apologize, but hopefully we made up for it with the yummy food from Hashawha, time to spend with family and friends for nice conversation, and of course the wonderful music from Mr. Lorne Lustig. So let's give him another... Thank you, Lauren. Jeff told me I had to introduce myself because not everybody's going to know who I am. I am the Lisa Carroll, the new Bureau Chief for Recreation. And I have been asked more than once if I am related to the Charles Carroll of O. Carrollton, if that's correct how you say that, who founded Carroll County. And the answer is no, I am not. But as I was researching that fact, I actually did find out, and for those of you who don't know, I am from Ohio, and ironically, there is a Carroll County in Ohio, and he did also, is also the founder of Carroll County in Ohio, which he founded before he founded Carroll County here, a couple years before, so I thought that was kind of ironic. But I am related to Charles Carroll, who happens to be my father-in-law, who does live in Catonsville, Maryland. So yes, I am related to Charles Carroll. Each year, Recreation and Parks recognizes its volunteers for giving their time and talents to benefit the community, and this year it's no exception. Everyone present tonight knows that without the dedication and support of volunteers like you, our programs and activities wouldn't be possible. And I'd like you to take a look around the room tonight. You might see faces of people you recognize, but more importantly, a group of women and men who work tirelessly year after year, creating positive change within our community. And I personally want to say thank you to each and every one of you for all that you do. And tonight is your night, and we're all here to celebrate you. Thank you. And I'd like to turn it over to Grant Slater. If you'd all please stand. Grant is with us from Winters Mill High School, and he will be singing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Thank you, Grant. All right, I'd now like to turn the microphone over to Judy Baker, Chair of our Recreation and Parks Advisory Board.
Congratulations to all the nominees for the year 2013. Thank you for all of your hard work that you have put in, the timeless hours that you have spent from your family to do what you do best of all. And that is why you're here this evening, to be recognized for the job well done. Again, thank you for everything you have done, and we greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, now we'd like to have Jeff Diggetts come up. Thank you, Jeff.
this point, I would like to introduce our two special guests this evening. We have a lot of special guests, but we have two up here on stage with us. We have Commissioner Doug Howard and Commissioner Haven Shoemaker. And I'd like to invite them both to come up and say a few words, if they'd like.
Well, good evening, everyone. Good evening. Come on now, all this enthusiasm you show on the ball fields now. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
All right, that's much better. You know, it is a pleasure to be here tonight. You know, first of all, Lisa, to your dilemma with your last name, my last name's Howard, and people often ask me if I'm related to John Eager Howard. And I used to say, you know, I've never looked into it, but I suspect not at all. And the closer I get to an election year, I say, you know, I've never looked into it, but it's entirely possible. So we talk a lot about what we do in government and really about the role of government being to provide public safety and infrastructure and education, and that's supported by economic development. So where does that leave recreation and parks? Where do you fit into the whole of the community? Well, I think really it's in two ways, and it's so incredibly critical. One is when we look at why people come to Carroll County, why people bring their businesses to Carroll County, why they invest in Carroll County, it is because of a thriving community, and a lot of that relates to the rec and park programs that we have. So give yourselves a round of applause, if you would please. But more importantly, community is more than budgets and decisions and things that we have to do in infrastructure. It is what goes on in these programs. And when we look at hundreds of programs and thousands of volunteers and tens of thousands of hours, you are what a big part of what makes Carroll County such a great place to be. And I just want to thank you for all that you do and say it's a pleasure to be here. And it's going to be fun to give out the awards tonight. Thank you.
It's an honor and a privilege for me to be here, too. I got to tell you, we have a tremendous spirit of volunteerism in this county. You all are certainly representatives of that fact. Thank you for what you do for the youth in our community and all those who participate in athletic programs throughout Carroll County. You all fill a role that government can't, and we certainly appreciate that. So thank you all for being here tonight, and it's an honor for me to be here, too. Thanks.
Don't worry. This is not a night for long speeches. But I do have a couple things that usually that gets a big round of applause. I would like to take a few minutes to share some thoughts with you. First of all, I would like to thank Commissioner Howard and Commissioner Shoemaker for coming out tonight, and thank the Board of County Commissioners for recognizing the connection between what happens in recreation and parks and the quality of life for our residents. Last year alone, in addition to our normal operations, we opened a new dog park. We moved forward with the support of the commissioners on developing trails in Westminster and in Freedom area. We move forward with the addition of athletic fields and planning for athletic fields in South Carroll, and also the planning of a new park in Westminster. These things are critical to you all to be able to do your jobs. They're important to the citizens because they're out there in those facilities every day. So to the Board of County Commissioners, thank you very much for your support. We appreciate that. Recreation and Parks provides an awful lot of opportunities for various lessons that can be learned. It starts at a very young age. It's with all ages, all abilities. Many of those lessons occur out on the athletic field. You're learning about competition. You may be learning about teamwork for the first time. Coming in a beautiful facility like this, you may be challenged and learn how to tap into that creativity that we all have inside. But some of us, like me, are a little challenged when they try to get to it. Arts programs are a wonderful way to tap into that and teach those lessons. You go to our nature centers, people learn how to be better stewards of the environment. Very, very important thing, and important lesson to teach at an early age and then to carry those lessons through the rest of your life. We learn how to interact with our peers. It may start in clinic soccer at 5 years old, but you learn how to interact with the other 5-year-olds. You learn how to interact with the adults around you. who become mentors. You learn how to become better connected within your community. These are all lessons that happen through recreation and parks. Now, we have a wonderful school system, a tremendous library system, and a great community college. And these lessons are happening in addition to that. It's supplementing what's happening through those other areas. So it's a great, great thing that it brings to people's quality of life. Now, I mentioned about learning lessons. Not all the lessons are fun. Some of them are difficult. Some of them are painful. Earlier this year, we lost one of our volunteers, who's also a recipient of an award tonight. Richard Mike Ridgel was a victim of the tragic violence at the Washington, D.C. Naval Yard. He was a dedicated volunteer coach in the Westminster JC softball program, and his efforts there were appreciated and loved by all. We're very fortunate tonight. We have our family representatives. We also have the head of the former president and new president of JC softball. I know that program well. My daughter played in that program. I helped coach in that program. And that program, like many of our other programs, is like a family. And when you lose a family member, it hurts. And they've felt that pain. To the girls that he coached, Mike Ridgel was a mentor and a friend. To his family, he was a loving husband and father. And to his coworkers that day, he was a hero. And he ultimately lost his life while he was saving the lives of others. There's no greater definition of a hero. We ask that you please join us in a moment of silence in memory of Richard Mike Ridgel. Thank you. Before we meet tonight's award winners, I want to share a few things with you. On your way in tonight, you may have seen copies of our new annual report. Take some time to look at it. Bring one home with you. There's about 150 pictures in it. For no other reason, take a look through. You might be in there. You know, it can be a contest. You know, search through those pictures, try to find yourself. We think it tells a good story about what we do in recreation and parks and what you do for us and for the citizens of Carroll County. I want to thank Sandy Ox and the Carroll County Arts Council. This is a beautiful facility. If you haven't been here before, you need to come back. When you're here tonight, you need to explore a little bit, poke around. You do not have to leave Carroll County to experience quality arts. You have films, you have live theater productions, music, wonderful gallery exhibits, even a peep show, and yes, children can come to that. Lots of great stuff happening here. Thank you, Sandy, for hosting us tonight, and all of you, please come back. I want to take a minute to recognize and thank our staff. I feel very fortunate to work with staff who are committed and who love what they're doing. They do it well, and they know why it's important. That makes my job very easy. So thank you to all of you. Most of them are hiding in the back or they've been shepherding people around during the evening, but thank you for what you do. I appreciate it. Jackie Robinson once said, "A life is not important except in the impact that it has on other lives." That's one of those statements that'll make you think. I'd like to thank the 11,460 volunteers who will not be getting an award tonight. It sounds a little funny when you say it that way. They're not getting an award despite their 790,000 service hours. What do we tell these people? Try harder? Maybe next year? Oh, no, that's what we tell the St. Louis Cardinals. Maybe next year. Any Red Sox fans out there? Do I have any company? All right. Good. A life is not important except in the impact it has on other lives. Those people impact lives in their community every single day in a positive way. I want to thank the husbands and the wives and the children of the volunteers. When those phone calls come during dinner time, when you're trying to plan your vacation around the next tournament or Broadway performance, trip, or drama production, And all of a sudden, the Rec Council scenes, I see some nodding heads. Somebody's in trouble tonight, I think. You guys do that. You do it well. Families, thank you for putting up with that. Volunteers love what they do. It's important what they do. And your communities are a better place to live because of that. Finally, I want to congratulate each of this year's nominees, all of our volunteers of the year. Your award is symbolic of a much larger pie, and you are one slice of that pie, but it's a very important slice, and what you do is incredibly important to your community. So I thank you for that. I hope you enjoy the evening, and let's hear some great stories about our volunteers and what they do. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Mark Slater, and I will have the distinct pleasure of presenting each one of the Volunteer of the Year recipients to you. And we have a program, but we're going to go out of order, as often happens. Jeff spoke of Mike Ridgel and his passing. We were going to save that for the end of the program. Members of the Ridgel family are here this evening. They have had a long, arduous day, and asked to go earlier in the program. So we're going to start there. How this is going to happen, I'm going to finish whatever little write-up I have about. People are going to come to the right of the stage and up the steps across the stage, and one of the commissioners will present recipients with the plaque. Then you'll have an opportunity to actually take the podium and say a few words if you would like. You aren't obligated to do that, but you can if you would like, and then you'll exit down those steps again where you came up. So that's the basic process. So here we go. Mike Ridgel had been a coach in Westminster girls softball for over 15 years. His last 4 years, he was an assistant coach with the junior division team, the Aces. His communication skills with the girls enabled him to excel as a coach. He was a man who knew that if you wanted girls to get better, you not only had to teach them the proper technique, but also encourage, cajole, and make them think they could do it. He did that with his quick smile, encouraging words, and positive attitude, endearing him to the players and making them to believe that they could do anything. I guess that doesn't sound any different than what any coach would do, but Mike lived it with his team, every day with his job, and his daughters. It is a sad time when our community loses a man of Mike's character. He is irreplaceable. In the eyes of those who knew him, Mike Ridgel is the size and shape of a hero. And I want to bring up Maddie and Tracy Ridgel to accept on his behalf. And it looks like Coach Tom's coming too.
I just like to say a couple things real fast. I'm obviously here on behalf of Mike tonight. We wore our team jackets because Mike and I were really proud of our team. And I'm so happy to be standing up here next to Maddie. The one thing I really want to say to everybody out there, to any program directors, I'm the past president of the league. I've been attending the Rec Council meetings for about 7 years. And every year when this would come up, it always seemed like the directors of the programs almost were hesitant to nominate someone for Volunteer of the Year. I'm really sorry, after all the years of being in the program, that I didn't take it more seriously. I know that if Mike would be around, he would have loved to come up here and receive this honor. I want to make sure that I urge all the program directors, anybody that's on any of the program's board of directors, to take this award seriously. It's a shame that we lost a man like Mike, and I just wish he was here, and we're all going to miss him. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, I think it is okay to applaud when people are coming up, too. You don't have to wait till they get up here. Okay, Carroll County Arts Council. The recipient is the Film Lovers in Carroll County, or FLICC, and the award will be accepted by Frank Baylor, the president. So let me just go through this real quick, and then we'll invite Frank up here to accept the plaque. Film Lovers in Carroll County, or FLICC, was formed in 2007 in an effort to ensure that the Carroll County Arts Council movie selections were representative of its diverse audience base. In addition, the Arts Council needed energetic volunteers to promote the films, to usher, to sell popcorn, to take tickets, to clean up, and to secure financial support. FLICC has ably served in this capacity for the past 6 years, and because of their efforts, the Arts Council movie audience has grown, and a loyal following has been established. Carroll County Arts Council is proud to collectively honor the FLICC group, the Film Lovers in Carroll County, and their tireless president, Frank Baylor, for such dedicated service on behalf of the Carroll County Arts Council. Let's give them a hand. You'd think after all the time in the theater, they would notice it on the end if they're going to come up. This looks like more than just Mr. Baylor. It's the whole group.
As you can see, this is a group effort. FLICC is the group of volunteers who help bring art, who help bring film to the Carroll County Arts Center. It's my honor and privilege to accept this award on their behalf. And this is just the tip of the iceberg here. Thank the Arts Council for recognizing us and Parks and Rec. Thank you very much, and see you at the movies.
Though I don't expect we'll have a whole row out of the audience coming up again, when it is your time, and you'll know it's your time, you can begin making your way to the stage as I'm speaking. That would be okay. Next is the Carroll County Equestrian Center. Recipients will be Michael and Jessica Dustin. While riding on the trails in the Union Mills area, Jessica Dustin noticed the signs announcing upcoming trail work days. She then realized the extent of the work done by volunteers to keep the trails open and accessible, and she wanted to help. The Carroll County Equestrian Council needed a coordinator for the Union Mills trail work days. Jessica did not hesitate to volunteer and has actively recruited additional volunteers. When asked to describe the perfect trail, Jessica's reply was, "A trail with beautiful scenery, a natural surface, open, well-maintained, and easy to get to. My favorite places to ride are Union Mills and Morgan Run." Mike Dustin provides the skills of the construction trade and power and support to Jessica's involvement. Together, working on various trails, they are an example of how one family can make a difference, teach trail stewardship, and ensure safe trails for future generations. Jessica and Mike Dustin are a vital part of Carroll County Equestrian Council and the council's 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
Before I accept this award, I need to let you know that I am not Justin and Mike Dustin. They could not be here this evening. I am the president of the Carroll County Equestrian Council, so I'm accepting that on behalf of them.
Let's give her a hand for being a good acceptor. Okay, Central Carroll Recreation Council is going to honor Lona Greensfelder. Is Lona here? Okay, good. There we go. Lona Greensfelder has been the foundation of the Central Carroll Rec Council for more years than anyone could count. I'm not sure who wrote that, but it's a nice compliment if you think about it. Her ability to remember and relate past experiences to items is invaluable to the council. Her willingness to volunteer long after her family members have stopped participating shows her dedication to the community and the Recreation Council. Lona is the council's treasurer and handles the finances in a timely manner without issues or mistakes. Central Carroll Rec Council is very lucky to have her, and she is the Central Carroll Rec Council 2013 Volunteer of the Year. Let's give her a hand.
Thanks to Central Carroll for nominating me, and I wanted to say when I started attending, we were Deer Park Rec Council. We have since merged with Sandy Mount, and Judy Baker was our president at that time, so we won't say how long ago that was. but I have been treasurer now for, I think, about 10 years, so I did want to thank my husband, who's with me tonight, Chuck, for never complaining. I said, for all the trips I take to the bank, and to Mechanicsville, to people to pick up money from instructors, and to the bank, to the post office. I've gone to people's houses. I go to Cranberry Station. I go to a variety of places to pick up cash and do whatever, because I don't do any of that for our home finances. He does everything. So, thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Chuck. Charles Carroll Recreation Council will be honoring two persons this evening, and I will just go through them individually. Mike Blizzard currently holds the position of president for Charles Carroll Recreation Council. Prior to this, he was vice president. He is a strong advocate for the program and has coached soccer, baseball, and softball, often several teams at once. Mike has been involved with the equipment and field maintenance for Charles Carroll programs and recently volunteered to build a concession stand at the Carroll County Sports Complex. He is a true asset to the Charles County Recreation Council, Charles Carroll Recreation Council, and a 2013 Volunteer of the Year. Let's welcome Mike Blizzard.
I'd just like to thank the Rec Council and Rec and Parks for the award and the nomination, and thanks to my family for the support. And actually, it's a time where we get to spend together and enjoy it very much. So thank you.
Mike Hott has been a strong coaching influence for the soccer, baseball, and softball programs. For many years, he has coached both indoor and outdoor soccer, again, coaching several teams at a time. Most recently, he has assumed responsibility of lining and maintaining the soccer fields, ensuring they're ready for each game. He works diligently with fundraising opportunities and is an advocate of the program and the community. Mike Hott, timeless, tireless, and diligent, and the 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
Thank you very much for the award, and I'll just share a quick story about coaching with you. Like a lot of things in life, you go out and you plan on helping others and kind of teaching others, and I've coached my daughter's team, who she's 13 now, and my son's 10. I've coached them for about 5 or 6 years, and you go out on the field and you think you're going to teach others stories and lessons of life, and too often they teach you. And every year I get to see other children kind of teach you things, and it's a true blessing. So thank you very much.
We're going to skip Harry. Where are we going? We have Ann Thomas. Okay. Our next recipient is the recipient from the Farm Museum Board of Governors. Harry Conover is the recipient, and he is not with us tonight, but Ann Thomas will be accepting the award on his behalf. Harry Conover, now age 79, a very young 79, retired from the business world in 1996 and was certainly not ready for the rocking chair. He decided to put his agricultural expertise, life experience, and abundant energy together to become the best volunteer he could be. Mr. Conover selected the Carroll County Farm Museum as the place to volunteer his time. His first volunteer position was when he was appointed by the Carroll County Commissioners to serve on the Carroll County Farm Museum Board of Governors. Mr. Conover served in that capacity from 2003 to 2008 and was elevated to the chair, subsequently completing 2 3-year terms. Mr. Conover was very instrumental in the pursuit to obtain one of the oldest log barns in the state of Maryland, now known as the Hoff Barn. He wrote a grant working in cooperation with the Maryland Historic Trust to support the reconstruction of this barn, and he continues to fundraise to support maintenance costs. Mr. Conover, along with members of the Pleasant Valley Lions Club, completed construction of a covered bridge. Mr. Conover initiated a largest pumpkin contest during the Fall Harvest Days event and developed a corn cannon to be used at various festivals. He is also a volunteer at the museum gift shop. All this adds up to over 2,000 volunteer hours and being selected the 2013 Farm Museum Board of Governors Volunteer of the Year.
Well, as you can tell, I am not Harry Conover. But on behalf of the Board of Governors, I'd proudly accept this on his behalf, and I'll make sure he gets that on our next meeting.
Next is Freedom Area Recreation Council, who will be honoring Christopher Little. Chris Little has lived in the Eldersburg-Sykesville area for 10 years, and there is not one person who has not seen him around town putting his time in recreational sports in the Freedom area. Mr. Little has been volunteering ever since his son began playing soccer in the Freedom Area Soccer Organization. He has not only coached countless soccer teams over the 10 years, he currently holds the position of president for Freedom Soccer Club. He has also been involved in the Freedom Area Basketball League for many years as a coach for his son's team, and has now taken on the role of commissioner for the Girls Travel League, where he coaches his daughter. Mr. Little has volunteered to coach teams for the Freedom Lacrosse and dedicated countless hours to volunteering to help out with numerous fundraisers. Chris Little is truly the quintessential volunteer. He truly cares about the children in his area and wants to provide them with the best possible programs. He leads by example, showing the meaning of hard work, passion, and commitment, which everyone within the community benefits from. Freedom Area Rec Council is proud to honor Chris Little, its 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
And I, like many of you, want to thank my family, Michelle, my son Hunter, and Caroline. But I think too many times when you're involved with rec councils as a program within a larger council, you don't get a chance to thank the people that do a tremendous amount of work at the top. We honored one tonight from one of the rec councils, but I want to thank a good friend, Ken Whalen, who is Freedom Area Rec Council president, as well as a very good friend, Chrissy Elliott, who supports me not only in our soccer programs, but as a good friend as well. So thank you.
In his comments earlier, Jeff mentioned the Friends of Bennett Cerf Dog Park, and that's our next recipient we're going to recognize. When Bennett Cerf Dog Park opened in March of 2013, Keri Magee was one of the first to sign her dogs up for a membership. From the beginning, she has been an enthusiastic supporter and cheerleader for the new park. Jumping in without hesitation, she has taken on the lead role of communicating with members, updating bulletin boards, maintaining the scrapbook, and collaborated with the City of Westminster for the Doggy Dip and Fall Fest events. Keri Magee, Friends of Bennett Cerf Park 2013, Volunteer of the Year.
I wasn't prepared to give a speech tonight, but a friend of mine, when I met, told me that I needed to get involved in something, so nothing's more important to me than my dogs and a place for them to run loose. So I decided, went to the first meeting, and was pretty much volunteered for the things that I started doing. So there aren't many, very many of us that attend these meetings, so the more things that we needed, I didn't want to leave left undone, so I'm doing them. So join the park. New memberships will be available in December. Thank you.
Next, we have Friends of Hashawha and Bear Branch, who will be honoring Darlene Rohrbaugh. Every week, visitors to Bear Branch Nature Center are greeted by Darlene's cheerful smile. For the past few years, Darlene has generously donated her time to welcoming visitors, answering telephone calls, and keeping Bear Branch organized and running smoothly. She has been instrumental in the preparation of special events, specifically the Monarch Madness Festival and Hashawha's annual Pancake Breakfast. You can come over. I'll finish while you're standing here. Darlene is a dedicated volunteer and Bear Branch Nature Center truly fortunate to have her bright, optimistic attitude shine when visitors walk through the door. Friends of Hashawha and Bear Branch 2013 Volunteer of the Year, Darlene Rohrbaugh.
I'd like to thank Hashawha, Bear Branch, and the Council for this special honor. As an employee of Carroll County Recreation and Parks for the 35 years, I saw firsthand the dedication of volunteers and how much they contribute to their communities and the county. Now, as a retiree, I'm able to be one of those volunteers at Bear Branch and Hashawha. These are unique facilities that provide great programs, which they do with a very small staff. So I'm happy to help out wherever I'm needed. It's been rewarding and a learning experience as well. Also, thank you to Recreation and Parks for recognizing all the volunteers. Thank you.
North Carroll Recreation Council will recognize two of their volunteers. So we have two for North Carroll. First would be Frank Ward, someone who gives so much time to make a program successful for the benefit of children defines Frank Ward. For the past 4 years of attending meetings, working with numerous teams, spearheading fundraising, ordering equipment, and the never-ending task of field maintenance. Never a complaint, and always, what can I do next? Taking time away from family and using his vacation time, he is an asset to the North Carroll Hotshots program and their players. From those you serve so diligently, a big thank you. Frank Ward, a North Carroll Rec Council 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
On behalf of the North Carroll Hotshots, I'm very honored to receive this award. It definitely caught me off guard. I can't say thank you enough to my family. Wait. It's really got me choked up. I'm very honored. I thank the coaches and I thank Mike Hernandez for doing what he does with the Hotshots, and I'm very grateful for this award. I'm very honored. Thank you.
Thank you, Frank. Next, Heidi Lippy Sprinkle. That's just fun to say. Heidi Lippy Sprinkle is always first to volunteer to assist in any way possible. In a nutshell, she is always there for everyone. In her last 2 years, while continuing to volunteer as team parent for her daughters, multiple teams, daughters stand up so we know that she's volunteering to be for multiple daughters, team mom teams. She has also assisted the North Carroll lacrosse program administration in a significant expansion of enrollment and communication efforts. She has taken on her various tasks with enthusiasm and energy, bringing a high level of organization and a fresh perspective to the program. When faced with a challenge, she always looks to find a way to get things done regardless of the obstacles. Heidi is one of the few people who believes that as volunteer, our job is to provide a better experience and leadership to the children our program is designed to serve. She leads by example, is always positive, and is a knowledgeable resource to those around her. Heidi Lippy Sprinkle's relentless commitment and involvement and her belief in helping to better the programs and community she lives in is why she is a North Carroll Rec Council 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
Well, I was shocked when I kept getting these congratulatory messages from all my friends. I got text messages and Facebook posts and emails. I'm like, what are you talking about? What is this? And then I realized somebody sent me the email and told me what it was, and I was blown away. I was so honored. I have three girls. I have a wonderful husband. My dad's here as well. John Harold, thank you for all those kind words. I love lacrosse, I love soccer, but I love my girls, and that's where they are, so that's where I want to serve. So it's just a mom and a dad out there serving to make the world a better place for where their girls are going to be. So thank you so much. It's such an honor. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Okay, Piney Run Recreation and Conservation Council. Hannah Schoff grew up as a camper at Piney Run, so it wasn't a surprise that a school trip abroad did not deter her from making it to camp the next day. Bleary-eyed and tired, she showed up with a smile on her face, ready to be the first to volunteer for any task needed, from fishing to working with different age group campers. In addition to camp, Hannah initiated a project for improving the park by painting steps with a slip-resistant paint, ensuring the safety of park patrons. Armed with her own team of volunteers, paint, and a smile, her group completed the steps that are still used by park patrons today. Join me in welcoming Hannah Schoff, the 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
Just really excited to be here. It's quite an honor to be here. I would love to thank the Piney Run Park Council for nominating me, and my friends and family for being here. And I have to say, I have a lot of fun volunteering. It's really just exciting and interesting for me to do, to get me out of the house in the park with nature. It's really incredible. And all I have to say is, tomorrow's my birthday, so this is a pretty awesome birthday present. Thank you.
Okay, for those of you who didn't know, there was a chance that we were going to rename the 2013 Volunteer of the Year ceremony into the Darlene Rohrbaugh ceremony. She is also nominated and the recipient of the Seniors in Action Volunteer of the Year Award, so she'll be back up with us. Darlene became an active member of the Seniors in Action after she retired from Carroll County Rec and Parks in 2010, where she was administrative assistant to the director of Carroll County Rec and Parks. She quickly became a vital member of the board, taking over making reservations for the monthly luncheon meeting. Each month, Darlene handles the calls from the members calling in to make a change or change their reservation, which puts Darlene on the front line of communications with many members of the Seniors in Action. Often, new members get her number and call her first, so she's the first experience they have with the group. Now she is liaison between the council and the caterer at the Elks Club. She ensures the smooth flow of communication between the membership and the Elks catering manager. Handling the complaints and special requests are all in a day's volunteer work for Darlene Rohrbaugh, the Senior in Action's 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
Well, I really feel special tonight and a little surprised. Again, when I worked in all those years, recreation and parks, Seniors in Action did a lot of planning for bus trips and so forth, all kind of trips. And my husband and I went on many of those trips. And we really liked it a lot. And when I retired, decided to continue with that group. They're a great group of people. We have a lot of fun. And I appreciate it very much. Thank you.
The Therapeutic Rec Council. Janet Garman has been a consistent source of help and support to Therapeutic Recreation and now Special Olympics Carroll County. The wonderful thing about Janet is her love for the Therapeutic Rec participants and the Special Olympics athletes. Her guidance and mentoring with the Girl Scouts, her friends and family has helped change the world one person at a time. Janet first started with the Therapeutic Rec drama program, working one-on-one with the actors. She then worked with the Girl Scouts to develop an inspiring video, which appeared on Channel 19, about our special needs population. Outstanding volunteerism and the Therapeutic Rec Council 2013 Volunteer of the Year, Janet Garman.
Thank you so much. I'd like to say a special thanks to Debbie Gemmel, who runs the Therapeutic Recreation Program. She was so open and welcoming to having our Girl Scout troop come in and work with the special needs population and community here in Carroll County. And it was incredibly heartwarming to see the interaction between our Girl Scouts and the members of that community and how everyone is so accepting of each other. So I've thoroughly enjoyed being a part of the Therapeutic Recreation volunteer community, and I'd like to thank my family as well. My parents are here tonight too, and all of you for everything that you do for Carroll County, and have a good evening. Thank you.
West Carroll Recreation Council will recognize Kim Palumbo as their 2013 Volunteer of the Year. Volunteerism often goes without notice. The rewards are personal and usually kept within one's own feelings. Only every once in a while an opportunity arises to allow a community to recognize an individual for their time and hard work. The West Carroll Recreation Council is very pleased to recognize one of its hardest working volunteers, Kim Palumbo. Kim has been involved in every program her children have participated in, including track and field, coaching spring baseball, and selling funnel cakes at the local Fireman's Carnival. Kim has dedicated countless volunteer hours with excitement and grace. As everyone within the recreation community knows, it takes many volunteers to make our programs thrive, but there are those few individuals that you can depend on to complete any task and to make a program run that much better. It would be hard to imagine any other person than Kim Palumbo that has given more of her free time on a consistent basis. And therefore, the West Carroll Recreation Council would like to recognize her as their 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
This is an honor, and first of all, I'd like to thank my family for the countless hours that I'm not at home. Most of the time, my kids and I are going out the door as my husband's coming in the door, and we don't get to see him for another 3 or 4 hours later. Like Heidi, I'm going to be where my kids are at. It gives me an opportunity to meet the parents and the kids that my kids are associated with, and I find pure pleasure and happiness and being around all the kids that I coach and help out. I want to thank you.
Okay, Winfield Recreation Council is going to represent, a whole family will be recognized as the Volunteer of the Year, the Berggren Family. For the Berggren Family, volunteerism and giving of their time is a family affair. Pete, Dad, helps with Winfield baseball field operations, attends numerous meetings, and oversees efforts to improve field conditions and facilities. His family is a crucial part of the organization's success. Julie Berggren, Mom, manages the concession stand, organizes dozens of volunteers, and maintains an efficient operation. Pete and his three sons, where are you? You should be moving up. Here you go. You should be moving up. Maintain all the baseball fields, mowing them weekly, and prepping them for game days. A true team effort. The Berggren family is the epitome of volunteerism. Collectively, they donate hundreds of hours each season to ensure that the Winfield baseball program is successful. The Berggren family is the first to lend a hand to any program endeavor, and Winfield Rec Council could not be the program it is today without them. The 2013 Volunteer of the Year family.
It was quite a surprise to be nominated for this. I have a wonderful family, and we work hard together. We play hard together, and they're a great supportive group. I appreciate Winfield Rec Council for nominating us and being here tonight. Thank you.
This is the last one.
We have one more award to give out, and I say that only because I don't want anybody skittering out immediately and crouching toward the door. We want to get pictures of all the recipients, so if you can please come up when we're finished and be available for the photo opportunities. Woodbine Recreation Council will recognize Brian Compton as the 2013 Volunteer of the Year. Brian Compton became involved in the Recreation Council in 2004 when his children became involved in football and cheerleading. Brian became an assistant football coach and then a head football coach in 2008 and continued until 2011. He continued coaching with the football program, served as assistant football commissioner, and currently is the co-football commissioner. He has coached baseball, basketball, and boys lacrosse, seeing a need for leadership in the MAYAA. Mr. Compton became vice president in 2011, and after his two-year term, ran for and became president, the position he now holds. Brian Compton is truly has donated all his spare time to the youth of Mount Airy and is the Woodbine Recreation Council 2013 Volunteer of the Year.
It's definitely an honor to be here this evening on behalf of the Woodbine Rec Council. I want to thank everyone that's here. You all obviously enjoy and love the passion that I also share to work with the children within our communities. I want to thank my loving wife who's here this evening. Not only does she put up with what we all do, what I do, she is definitely the backbone. It helps me out, and she also puts in countless hours with the program. I'd also like to thank the Department of Rec and Parks for all that you guys do in helping us with the leadership to get done what we need to get done. Thank the commissioners for all that they do here with us as well. It's definitely an honor to have the ability and the time to put in to work with the youth in the community. They are our future. We get the first chance to see what they're doing. We get to have that opportunity to put that impact in their lives. And we all see so many of them that have the possibility of going another direction, and we're there at that critical time to help and lead them and steer them in the right direction. I'd also want to thank and recognize Mr. Denny Ahold, who's here, for his kind words. He is one of the first people that I met when I came into Mount Airy. When I joined the program, when I got involved with the Rec Council, he's definitely been a mentor, helping me through and making it much more enjoyable year after year. And I truly appreciate everything that you all do. I enjoy it as much as you guys do. I want to thank everyone for the award. Thank you.
Well, this concludes the reward ceremony. I need to have all the recipients of awards up on the stage, and then there are refreshments in the little room where we started out, if you'd like to, everybody else would like to go there while we're taking some pictures. So thank you very much.